Hi, everybody, and I hope you're enjoying your holiday weekend. This is Deanna. I have something that I wanted to share with everyone, and I just want to start out the conversation by saying that I think that you should have a very trusted medical doctor of some sort that is your family doctor. And I would really suggest that that person is a very well-rounded and very open-minded person who's open to learning new things. If you talk to a doctor who's been practicing for a while, I think that what they'll tell you is that they learned limited amounts of information about what to do for people, and they are also looking for solutions. They're looking for natural solutions for their patients. They've tried to solve problems for people through all the things that they learned in medical school, like surgeries and medicines, and they have done their best. I really do believe that their intentions are good and that they're for the most part, and that they're there to try to help their patients. So this is not a happy holiday, Karen. This is not some sort of a criticism of doctors. So let's make sure that that's very clear. And I certainly believe that you should have a very good medical doctor in your corner. The best way to find one, I think, is to ask people. Ask lots and lots of questions before you put your healthcare into their hands. Over the course of my life, especially being very ill for about 20 years, I encountered a lot of medical professionals in all different parts of the country, of all different genders, graduating from all different types of universities and having lots of different specialties. And what I've noticed is that those who are open to learning are the best ones and the ones that helped me the most in my journey. But I have to tell you that I honestly believe that the reason I am sitting right here in this chair having this conversation with you Memorial Day weekend of 2019, and the reason that I'm able to enjoy the level of wellness that I have today, the reason that I have a son, the reason that our whole family enjoys the level of wellness that we do, is because of a person that had no medical experience, in fact, no training at all in the health industry. I am here because a person, a lay person, who many could say was not qualified to give advice, reached out to me. She never offered to fix me. She never offered me a cure. But she did say, did you know about this alternative treatment? And how can I serve you? Like, can I let you try something for free? She wasn't out to try to sell me something, although there's certainly nothing wrong with paying for things that somebody is selling. But I just felt that this was somebody that cared about people. And it's somebody that I had observed over the years, always trying to meet people's needs and serve them. And during a time in my life when I was struggling for, gosh, 5 or 6 years of really, really terrible, terrible issues with our health, my husband and I felt very abandoned and isolated by a lot of people, including our family and friends. And even though this person didn't live anywhere near me and really didn't have a prior friendship with me, they were constantly reaching out, asking if they could pray for me, asking how they could serve us. And so I knew when she reached out to me about an alternative solution that she was doing it because she cared. And so the reason I'm telling you this story is because I want two groups of people to hear this information. There have been multiple times in my life over the past 7.5 years when I have been using natural solutions as my, I guess, my go-to, my initial go-to. Now, that doesn't mean I fired my medical professionals, because I've definitely still used them. And at times I had surgeries during those years. I had a child by a cesarean section. All of these things required the use of medical professionals. I have medical professionals that are business partners. I have nothing against medical professionals. Okay, so hear me very well. But what I'm telling you is that of all the people who gave me help and information that changed my life, the most useful information I got was not from a medical professional. This was from a person who had experienced something natural that had worked in their own life. They had seen it work for others, and they just wanted to help me. And so please, if you are faced with an emergency situation, I am not saying don't go to the emergency room. I'm not saying don't go to the doctor. I'm not saying to go against medical advice. That's not what I'm saying here. But what I am saying is there are natural solutions out there that your doctor does not know about. I'm talking about you can be at the Cleveland Clinic, or you can be at Vanderbilt, or you can be at Johns Hopkins, and you can be talking to somebody that's at the top of their field, but they're in the traditional medicine arena. They don't know everything. Unfortunately, in our country, our healthcare is driven a lot by the pharmaceutical companies, and their main goal is to have lifelong customers, okay? So while I'm not telling you that all medications are bad and that there's not uses for medications, I have a spouse who lives daily, he's alive daily because of a pharmaceutical drug called insulin. So trust me when I say that I'm not against pharmaceuticals. What I am against is I am against withholding or preventing people from getting information that can be life-saving and that could change their health, that can save them a lifetime of illness and a lifetime of being bankrupt or just really suffering financially, emotionally, and physically because they don't know information. So when you talk to doctors who are really honest and that they have a real heart to help people, they're going to tell you they're limited of what they can do. I've had medical doctors that had no idea of the ingredients that are in vaccines. I've had medical doctors that had no idea that this medication and this medication interacted. I have had medical doctors that have never heard of certain things like herbs or essential oils or different treatments. And I have been the one as a layperson to introduce many of those things to many medical professionals that they now use with their patients. I remember the day that I had a surgeon who, highly specialized surgeon that owns a multi-million dollar surgical center in a major metropolitan city. And here I was probably like in almost 40 years old, and he had done a surgery on me when I was 12, and he was then getting ready to perform a procedure on my infant child. So he's been doing this for a minute, okay, if you can do some math there. And I was able to use a natural solution with my child that was absolutely so astounding and amazing to him that he had never heard of or had any idea about, that he actually asked me where could he go and get more training about that and how could he start using that with his patients. And so I'm telling you this because I've had multiple doctors tell me there's nothing more they can do for me, that there was no solution to my problem, that I was going to die, that I would be unable to ever have children, that I'd never be able to drive a car, that I'd never be able to get off of many of these medications that I was taking, that I'd always have to use a wheelchair. I've been told a lot of things, and I don't believe those people intended to hurt me or necessarily were out to keep me down or keep me sick or keep me broke. I think they were doing the best they could with the information they had. And for that reason, I'm going to ask you to please be open to somebody in your life. There is a person in your life who you have personally known that has overcome serious injury, serious illness by using natural solutions. I have a friend who was diagnosed with breast cancer a couple years ago, and she chose, as is her right, by the way, she chose to go through alternative routes instead of the traditional like radiation, chemotherapy, surgical procedures. Do you want to say hi? And she actually got a lot of criticism from her church because she decided to go a natural route instead of the traditional route. And do you know that after following a very strict regimen of diet and herbs and supplements and essential oils and whatever, that she got a clean bill of health, and then she went to her church and told them, and they were like, well, you didn't do chemo and radiation, so you never had cancer to start with. And I was just like, wait a second. So instead of rejoicing that this person found something that worked, we're wishing that they were still sick so we could prove that it didn't work. What's missing here? And so not everybody is gonna have an open mind to natural solutions, but you know somebody like this girl who's overcome breast cancer naturally. So perhaps if your doctor is giving you a really bad, poor prognosis, or if the treatment that he's prescribing, once you've done your own research, please do your own research. Once you've done your own thorough research on the treatment that he's prescribing and you've had a chance to think about what you would like to do with your body, remember that whole my body, my choice thing? I'm wondering why it only applies in some situations now. I'm just confused. That was a free little side note. But once you've done your own research and made your decision, if you still don't feel comfortable with that treatment, why don't you ask the person that you already know overcame that? Ask them what they would do or what they did do. You don't have to do what they did necessarily, but get all the information. Get a second opinion. Get a third opinion. See different kinds of doctors, okay? If you're seeing somebody who specializes in cancer, and in our country, the main treatments for cancer are pretty much chemo and radiation, you're probably going to get a recommendation for surgery, chemo, or radiation, right? So maybe see somebody who does something different and just see what they have to say. Explore all your options and find a person who's not a medical professional, who's just a person that wants to tell you their experience. Another area that I want you to think about, just think about it, take your emotions and set them down over here for a second, okay? And let's think about another topic like vaccines, okay? It's a hot topic right now. It might be a more of a hot topic than the whole like Hillary, Donald Trump thing during the election last year, man. I have had to like unfollow so many posts because of the vaccine drama where people are like threatening to hurt one another because they disagree on this topic. What I want you to ask yourself is if you know a person who is really working hard to provide education about how vaccines can cause death and side effects, which is 137% true, by the way. If you're looking at them thinking like, what is their motivation? What are they getting from that? Like, are they getting paid by the undrug companies to tell you not to take a vaccination? Like, what is their motivation? Are they just a weirdo? Are they like a conspiracy theorist? I bet you if you really ask them what was their motivation, I actually see some of these people here, person that are on here watching. That they've actually had a personal vaccine reaction or they've actually known somebody that's had one. And so their only motivation is I went down this path and it was really hard and very painful and I don't want you to be on that path. So I'm like, I've been down this road and I know there's like a big giant cliff that you're getting ready to fall off. And so I'm like flagging my arm saying, don't go this way, don't go this way. Okay, on the other side of the argument, you have some people who stand to make a whole lot of money if everybody suddenly no longer believes in what they offer. So when you're looking at someone's intentions, let's look at like who has the greater thing to lose here, okay? And so I want you to consider that also when you're considering alternative treatments. Now, I'm not gonna tell you that there are not alternative medicine doctors that are out there because they really want more customers. They like want you to keep coming back and getting that same knot in your back, cracked out or rubbed out or whatever every single week. I'm just saying like, be wise. Okay. Don't just throw your money at everything. We threw our money at everything out of desperation for decades and wasted probably close to $1 million trying to figure out solutions and went down paths that really hurt my body and hurt us emotionally and hurt us financially and hurt our chances of having a child and just lots of heartache. And so, when I started being open to people who didn't have certain medical degrees, that's when I started to find my answers. I remember a friend reached out to me and said, read this book. I read the book. I remember my mom reaching out and saying, read this book. I read the book. Not everything that you see and is recommended to you is going to be the thing, but open your mind because some of the best answers are there and they're not readily available. Like you're not going to see it on the news and you are maybe not going to hear about it from your doctor. And so if you're looking for somebody official to give you information, that's not how it necessarily always works. Okay. It's like the story about the guy who was drowning in the flood and he's like, God save me. And God sent him a guy in a boat and a helicopter. And he's like, no, thanks. I'm waiting for God to save me. Sometimes we pray for answers and God gives us a little insurance lady that lives 1,000 miles away that says, hey, have you ever tried this natural solution? Sometimes that's the airplane or the helicopter that he sends our way. And it doesn't come wrapped up in the package that we want. It doesn't come with like a MD after their name, or it doesn't come with, you know, a multi-million dollar practice that they've been running. It doesn't come with a PhD or science degree or whatever. And so I just want you to know that everybody out there that has found a natural solution to something, I don't care if it's a cold sore, if you found a natural solution out there that's worked for you, please open your mouth and share it with somebody who's struggling. We already do that as humans. It's like natural to do, you know, like guys that are watching, I know there's some guys watching. So you're like, you see a friend of yours out there and he's fixing his car and you see that he's like, you've already tried that before. And you already know that if you do that, like you're going to jam that bolt in there and then he's going to have to spend $1,000 to get a highly specialized tool to get that bolt out. You could walk over to your neighbor and say, hey buddy, like, let me stop you before you waste a whole bunch of time and money and frustration and like break your car worse. Isn't that human nature? So when it comes to health, I think like there's been so much stigma and so much propagandizing of people who use natural solutions. Like we have funny names for those people, like they're crunchy granolas, they're conspiracy theorists, they're mummy bloggers. Like we make fun of people who question the norm or the status quo or like what everybody wants you to think, if no one questioned anything, we would all still be just having, you know, are gutted open by surgeons that hadn't washed their hands since they touched cadavers. Like, we have to pass information along as we learn it. Okay. If you remember, there was a woman who was the one who questioned all the male surgeons and said, y'all need to be washing your hands before you're delivering babies here. Like, you're, all these women are dying in childbirth because you've got germs all over your hands, bacteria. And because she was a woman and because, you know, women didn't belong in medicine, people didn't listen to her for a really long time. Let's not be those people. Okay. If you have a solution, I don't, you know, somebody might look at you askance. They might say, mind your own business. You don't know what you're talking about. Or they might say, thank you for changing my life, which is what I'm saying to my friend Lisa, who opened her mouth and shared with me when she wasn't qualified and she didn't know that it was going to help. And she just was hoping that she could offer me something, some relief. And so if you have a medical issue, I don't care how serious it is, and I don't care if the doctor told you there's no other solutions, reach out and ask people that you know that have gone another route, that have found solutions, and ask them if they know of anything. If you're a person who's experienced something, big or small, and you see someone else experiencing that, wave your arms and say, hey, I've already been down this road. It's not safe. Don't go that way. Please don't go that way. At the end of the day, you know whose decision it is. It's theirs. It's their decision. But don't hold back information out of fear. Don't hold back information because you don't think you're qualified. Some of the most unqualified people are doing 1,000 times more than the most credentialed people that are out there. You know why? Because they have courage and they have compassion. If you have courage and compassion, you can change the world with that. Because you know what? I don't know everything. I've had in the past 6 years of doing my health and wellness business, I have learned a lot of things, and I've been able to help a lot of people in some really dire situations. Babies, family members, my own family. And I still don't know everything, but you know what? I have learned a lot. And when I don't know something, I know people that I can ask because of the huge network that we've created in the health and wellness industry. And that is what's so beautiful about what I do. Hey, Annie, it's good to see you. That's so beautiful about what I do. And those of you that are watching that are in the health and wellness field, please open your mouth. Okay. Who cares? If somebody might mock you, somebody might say no thanks, but it's the ones that say yes and thank you, and you were in their path for a reason. It's their decision whether to accept the information or not, but don't hold it back because you don't know for sure and you're not sure if that what their response is going to be. You can save a life. You can literally save a life. So I'm just here to tell you, I have never once seen a situation where somebody's been told there was no hope, that there wasn't still some hope somewhere. Never even one time. And I have been told on multiple occasions personally there was no hope, with myself, with my close family members, friends all over the country. I could tell you story after story. There's things that I really can't say on such a public live video. But I have seen miracles happen because people were willing to open their minds, open their hearts, and open their mouth. If you will participate in that movement, this is how we change our healthcare system. If you don't know that it's broken, I don't know where you've been. Okay. We're spending more money than almost anybody in the world, and we're not doing so great as health wise. Okay. We've got a long, long way to go. So what we're doing is not working. It's time to open your mind to some new things and open your mouth and share the things that you know with your neighbors, with your friends and your family. Don't be afraid. And you know what's really cool is in a lot of cases, you don't have to choose this or this. You can combine them together and you can speak up. Doctors and government officials do not get to make decisions for your body. At least at this moment, we still have some rights. We still have informed consent. We still have the ability to make decisions for our underage children as parents. And don't let anybody tell you otherwise. You do have that right. You do need to take it seriously and research everything that is injected into your body, everything that's put into your body, everything that you're eating, where is it coming from? We need to ask better questions and stop trusting blind faith in people that are there to line their pockets on the fact that we're believing what we're told. I've never been very good at believing what I was told. I've never been very good at doing what I was told. And thank God, and that's why I'm sitting here having this conversation. And that's why I'm gonna help lots and lots more people in my life. These are the kind of people it takes to change something that's not working, is people who are willing to speak up and say, there's another way to go. And I know this person told you that, and I'm sure that they're not a bad person, but they only have this much knowledge. Open your mind to new possibilities And the people that don't necessarily always behave and stay in between the lines, those are the ones that have the answers you're looking for in a lot of situations. So when you have a dire situation, somebody's hurt, somebody is sick, somebody is dying, ask questions. Go to the people that you know that have had big life changes using alternative treatments and say, what do you know? Who can you connect me to? Research the crap out of everything. Never give up. Ask God for help. You know, that's really where it begins. And then listen when he brings you the help. The Bible says that if you lack wisdom, ask of God. He gives it to all men liberally. Like, he gives you what you ask for. He doesn't make you feel stupid for asking. And he gives you everything that you need to know. He has all the wisdom. He has all the people. They're probably already all in your life already, but you've already labeled them. Oh, that's that crazy oil lady. That's that crazy crunchy lady. And they're there in your life, and they could save your life or the life of your loved one if you would be willing to open your heart and open your mind and listen when God provides the answer in a package that doesn't look like what you expected. And if you're that person that has those answers, don't hide it under a bushel. That's a light that God has given you to share in the world. Don't be afraid to speak the truth. Don't overpromise, but give hope to people. People are looking for hope. Don't be afraid to give it to them. Don't be afraid to share what you know and share what you have. And, you know, we have a lot to give in the world if we don't live in fear. And fear is really the driving force behind why we don't speak and why we don't ask and why we just trust in blind faith people who have no personal experience with what we're going through. There's something powerful about personal experience that you can't get from a book, that you can't get from a degree. And so make sure that you include those people in your research and your decision-making process so that you don't overlook something that can be life-changing. And I'm just grateful that I had those people in my life that were willing to do that for me. And I'm grateful that I was able to recognize it when it came into my life, because that's why I'm here having this conversation. Enjoy your holiday weekend with your friends and family. Love your family. You don't know how long you have with them. And please be safe. Don't drink and drive. If you're going to be drinking out there, please use a designated driver. Stay over at the person's house. Whatever you need to do, think about not just the people in your vehicle, but those out there driving on the road. And have a great weekend. Let's not forget those who are being celebrated this weekend. And their intention was to keep us safe and protected, and that was what their goal was. And they did give their lives, and their goal was to give their lives for our country. So we should honor their sacrifice. And thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned something. I hope you're inspired. Shine on.